80. What is it? Let me see. Please. 80. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, point number 79 in the book شرح السنة. شرح السنة بالإمام البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى, in which he explains the أصول of أهل السنة والجماعة, الحديث, the فرقة الناجية, in their aqidah, in the methodology in which they tread upon. And from those usul, according to Imam al-Barbahari, that we should know it is not permissible to hide sincere advice from any of the Muslims, whether the Muslim is pious or impious in matters of the deen. Whoever hides that has acted deceitfully towards the Muslims. Whoever acts deceitfully to the Muslims, he has done so towards the religion. Whoever acts deceitfully towards the religion has behaved treacherously towards Allah Azza wa Jal, towards his messenger, and towards the believers. This issue of al-Nasiha, al-Imam al-Barbahari considered it to be from the asul of al-Salafiyya, to be willing and ready to give advice to those Muslims who you know and those who you don't know, those who are younger, those who are older, to those individuals who are religious and those who are irreligious. The point is that the person is willing and ready to give a nasiha. And that's because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has brought a religion in which he informed us, la yu'minu ahadukum hatta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsihi min al-khayr. None of you truly believes. You are not a real believer until you love for your brother what you love for yourself from that which is good. From that which is good. So everyone wants to be advised concerning those things that he may not know. So he has to be willing and ready to give advice to others. Not to do so is a form of deceiving and deceiving that particular Muslim. Allah Ta'ala has established in the book of Allah, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Verily, the believers are brothers. And since the brother has been established, the brotherhood has been established, everyone has to be willing and ready to give advice. So the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in this regard has mentioned a number of issues. He mentioned that the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal is giving advice. Ad-deenu nasiha. Ad-deenu nasiha. Ad-deenu nasiha. The religion is giving good advice, giving it good advice, giving good advice. They said, to who, Ya Rasulullah? Giving good advice to who? He said, it's giving good advice to Allah. Wali kitabihi. Wali rasulihi. Wali a'immati al-muslimin wa ammatihim. Having a nasiha to Allah, having nasiha to the Prophet, nasiha to Allah, to his book, to the Prophet, to the leader of the Muslims and the regular people. The meaning of having nasiha to Allah Azza wa Jal is having ikhlas. The word nasiha comes from the fi'l al-thulathi nasaha. Nasaha, which means to make something pure. Akhlasa, to make something pure. So having nasiha to Allah Azza wa Jal is not advising Allah, but having ikhlas. Worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal alone, without any partners and without making any shirk. Believing in Allah, having husn al-dhan about Allah. As Allah Azza wa Jal said in authentic hadith al-Qudsi, Ana inda dhan abdi bi. In dhan khayran, for ana kadhalik. I will be according to the way my slave thinks I am. If he thinks good about me, I'm going to be like that. The slave has a problem. Something is bothering him or her. There's something going on. They have to have a good opinion about Allah. They can't say crazy things. They can't do crazy things. Instead of committing suicide and killing themselves, leaving the religion, they turn to Allah Azza wa Jalla in dua and sincerity. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will help them because they had a good opinion about Allah. So that's part of an-nasiha lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the nasiha to the book of Allah, again, it's being sincere. الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. Those people read the book the way it's supposed to be read. وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Read the Qur'an with tajweed. Read it correctly. Nasiha to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal is reading it, learning how to read it, memorizing it, studying it. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Do they not consider the Qur'an and contemplate the meaning of the Qur'an? Or do they have over their hearts locks? So a person has to make time to try to unlock the treasures and the mysteries of the Quran, to comprehend the kalam of Allah. The Prophet told us in an authentic hadith, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, من أراد أن يعلم ما له عند الله فلينظر ما لله عنده. Anyone who wants to know his position with Allah, then let him look at Allah's position with him. If you choose the Quran over wasting time with this or that, then that's a sign and indication that Allah Ta'ala is pleased with you. But if you prefer to listen and to watch things instead of the Quran, that's a sign, that's an indication that Allah Ta'ala may not be pleased with you. So people cannot afford to have this position where we're tired of listening, we don't want to listen to, we don't want to read, we don't want to learn the Kitab of Allah. How can it be possible that the Muslim says that I'm bored and he can spend time with the book? The companion of Abdullah ibn Abbas, his name was Mujahid. Anytime he had free time, he would take the Mus'haf, kiss the Mus'haf, and he would say, it's the book of my Lord, the book of my Lord. And he would read the Quran. So having ikhlas, making halal, halal in the Quran. Haram, haram in the Quran. Respecting it, honoring it when it gets old. And the person wants to discard it and get rid of it. He doesn't throw the Quran in the garbage. He doesn't throw papers of the Quran, pages of the Quran in the bin. He burns it, having respect for the book of Allah. That's al-ikhlas, practicing it, calling to it, defending it, having his children to memorize it. And nasiha is given, the deen is given nasiha to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has two meanings. During his lifetime, advising him. Ya Rasulullah, let us do this and let us do that with the captives. Ya Rasulullah, make this person the Amir over the tribe. Ya Rasulullah, as his wife said, and he took advice from his wife, when your companions did not want to come out of their ihram because they wanted to insist to go forward and to fight these kuffar, since they're not listening to you because they want to go and fight, then you take your ihram off. Once they see you out of your ihram, they're going to follow suit. So giving advice to the Nabi during his lifetime, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that way, giving him nasiha, which is a proof and an indication that he's not hazir nazir. It's a proof and it's an indication he doesn't have the ilm al-ghayb. The reason why we have to have nasiha and we give nasiha is because everyone here, he has a blind spot. There are things that are going on in his life that he doesn't know about. His children are out in the street. His wife is out in the street. Husband is out in the street. Someone is doing something who's under your supervision. You don't know. And you don't have an idea of what's going on. Someone walks to you and say, I saw your son doing A, B, C. So you need to do this, you need to do that. He looks at you and he says, this thing is on you and it's not correct. You have a foul odor coming from you. You may not know that odor is coming from you. Nasiha comes as a result of a person not always seeing his own deficiency and his blind side. So the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to have the ability to see behind his head in the salah sometimes, but didn't have the ability to see everything. So his companions would give him advice during his lifetime. Nasiha to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after his death is being from the Ansar al-Sunnah. Making Hajj, Allah Ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, فَمَنْ تَعَجَّلَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ وَمَنْ تَأَخَّرَ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ. Whoever after 2 days in Mina, he wants to leave. He wants to leave Mina. He doesn't want to stay for an extra day. He stones before Maghrib and he gets out of there. He can do that and there's no harm, no problem. But nasiha to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is trying to stay that extra day because it's the sunnah. It's not something you have to do, but it is the sunnah. Being from the Ansar of the sunnah, people who defend the sunnah, people who spread the sunnah, people want to be on the way of the sunnah, love the sunnah. He doesn't care what people think. There is a sunnah that he wants to bring to the attention of the people. He doesn't think twice. They're going to say this, they're going to say that, they're going to think this, they're going to think that. He introduces it in a way, inshallah, that is appropriate and the people are ready for it. But he doesn't think twice. It is the sunnah, let's do it. And when he hears the sunnah for the first time, he never knew it before, but when he came to hear it for the first time, he embraces it. That's the sunnah, that's giving nasiha to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Having ikhlas towards his sunnah, reading the books of al-hadith, studying the books of al-hadith, trying to be as much as we possibly can on the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ad-deenu nasiha is also giving advice to the imams of the Muslims. One of the distinguished factors and characteristics of Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Sunnah, is that they don't make khuruj against people in positions of authority. They advise those people, and they advise them in a way in which there's a minhaj. They don't advise them in front of the people. They don't advise them to make tashhir with them, to put them down and to embarrass them and to expose them. They also make dua for them in their absence, because in making dua that Allah Ta'ala rectifies the condition of the believer, the leader, then if he is corrected, then that benefit and that correction is going to touch everybody from the ummah. Instead, we find today with the political Muslims, Hizb ut-Tahrir, Muhajirun, Crusaders, those people, whatever they call themselves, what are they called again? Muslims against Crusades. These people, their religion is cursing the rulers. Cursing the rulers. We get rulers that we deserve. Rulers who are like us. We look at ourselves and we look at our wives. We look at how we deal with our wives. We look at how our wives deal with us. We look at us as people. We get rulers who we deserve. Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, Allahu bidhallamil al-abid. Allah is not oppressive towards his servants. He won't oppress the people just like that. He's going to give them. وَكَذَلِكْ نُوَلِّي بَعْضُ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. We're going to make some people responsible for others over them because of what they used to do. Because of what they used to do, we're going to give them people over them because of what they used to do. So the people of the Sunnah, they make dua for those rulers. In the khutbah and other than the khutbah, they ask Allah Azza wa Jal to guide them and to forgive them. They don't ask Allah to expose them, to break their backs. They don't make khuruj against them. And when they do advise them, they advise them off, away from the eyes and the ears of the people. The same way you expect to be advised by your wife. You're the imam, and you expect that your wife advises you between you and her. Not in front of your children, not in front of the neighbors, not in front of her relatives, not in front of her friends, and so forth and so on. Lastly, he said, and this is the point that Al-Imam Al-Barbahari is referring to, giving advice to the Muslims, to the regular Muslims. Ad-Din al-Nasiha, Ad-Din al-Nasiha, Ad-Din al-Nasiha. Giving advice to the Muslims, being sincere to them and advising them. The Prophet told us about our relationship with one another, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, and mu'min, mir'atul mu'min. The believer is a mirror to his brother. Jabir ibn Abdullah, he said, bay'atu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala an ubay' ala an ansah wa unasah kull muslim. I gave the Nabi the bay'ah. When I became a Muslim, I shook his hand, gave him the pledge of allegiance that I would give nasiha to every Muslim. I saw him doing something that was incorrect. The way he made sajda, he didn't put his feet the right way. The way that he made wudu, he wasted the water. He didn't get the water all over the place. Her hijab wasn't correct. Something that I saw, he took the bay'ah, whatever he saw, that he would say, this thing is not correct. That thing is not correct. That is what the Nabi used to give, the bay'ah to the people concerning it. Because again, this is an issue that is from the Asul of Salafiyya. How do we know it's from the Asul of Salafiyya? Another hadith. The Prophet told the people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْضَ لَكُمْ ثَلَاثًا وَيَكْرَهُ لَكُمْ ثَلَاثًا. Allah is pleased for three things that you do, and He dislikes three things that you do. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْضَ أَن تَعْبُدُوهُ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Allah is pleased that you worship Him and you don't make shirk with Him. The most important fundamental of a Salafiyya. When ta'tasimu bihablillahi wala tafarruqu. Allah is pleased that you unite and you stay united amongst yourselves and don't be divided. Another asul from the asul, the fundamentals of al-hadith. Wa yarda lakum an tanasahu man walla Allahu amrakum. And Allah loves that you give advice to those people that Allah has put in authority and in charge of your affairs. You travel with a group of people and there is an emir from that group of people. That person or those people have been put in charge of your affairs. People who know the minhaj is Salafi, when they travel with those type of people, with that emir, with that imam, they're going to deal with him a certain way. People who are ignorant, they're just ignorant. They don't know what they're doing. They're going to handle that in a way that they see fit. They'll make khuruj with their kalam, khuruj with the lisan, khuruj with their actions. They'll encourage other people to make khuruj. And this is why, ikhwani, is imperative that we learn the deen, we learn the deen, we learn the deen. Learning the deen helps you to be a person who knows how to be in the group when you travel. I don't like what's going on. I don't like what you said. I don't like the decision that you made. But I know from the asul of this deen is that we have to be united and I have to give advice to the leader in a particular way that's going to bring about the best issue. So the shahid here is, Al-Imam Al-Barbahari rahimahullah ta'ala did not bring this point just out of his head like that. He thinks advice is important, which it is. So he just says, I'm going to make it from the asul of the sunnah. La. There are dalils that show and indicate what he's talking about. He went on to mention, Khwani, concerning this particular issue, that we give nasiha to the religious ones and to the irreligious ones in the affairs of their deen. That doesn't mean that we don't give nasiha to the affairs of the dunya. You advise him, don't buy that car. That car over there is not a good car. But the reason why he didn't mention the dunya here is because the deen obviously is more important. If you're going to give him nasiha and the deen, that's the most important issue. It necessitates that you're going to give him nasiha in the dunya as well. Don't be too tough with your right wife. You have a good lady. Be easy with her. They are deficient. It's that time of the month. Do like this. Don't be like that. Don't be too rough. Don't be, and so forth and so on. He went on to mention whoever hides and holds back this nasiha, he has cheated the Muslims. He has made ghash. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, laysa minna man ghashana. Oh, man ghashana falaysa minna. Anyone who cheats us is not from us. We are having an exam right now. We're having an exam right now. You pass the paper out, and the brother says to the other brother, what's the answer? And he passes the answer out. He passes him the answer. This is not from the characteristics. Whoever cheats is not from us. He gives you faulty items and so forth and so on. Not to give people advice is a sign of cheating. It's a sign of cheating. Lastly, the Imam Rahimullah Ta'ala, he said, whoever cheats the Muslims, then he has cheated the deen, because the Muslims are from the deen and they make up the deen. And whoever cheats the deen, then he has effectively cheated Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all of the believers. We're gonna stop here, honey, inshallah. We'll do the next two or three in the next class on Tuesday, bidillah. If you brothers have any questions, you can put your questions forward. If you have anything. Halindakum shay. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum. Last day, I got sick and came back. The last day. It was Mecca because we got stuck in the traffic and all of the fuel was in my chest. Yeah, man. How's your dad? Everybody all right?